Hi, I'm Sharon Baumgarten, and I was lucky enough to participate in the SummerSTEM program 2019-2020, and I created an awesome project-based learning unit with my partner, Christy Roller. We both teach at Apex Middle School. I teach 8th grade science. I have been a teacher for 20 years, and 10 of those years are in New York City and 10 years in Wake County. As part of the SummerSTEM program, we had career immersion hosts. They hosted us, gave us a tour, and gave us information about their company. We were hosted by Duke Energy and Novozymes. In a partnership with Novozymes, I developed a relationship with Melissa Live. She is a process engineer for Novozymes, and she came to visit our school and present to our students. She was young, energetic, and smart, and a great role model and representative for careers in STEM. Our standard that we focused on in our project-based learning unit was 8L21 to summarize the aspects of biotechnology, including specific genetic information, careers, economic benefits to North Carolina, ethical issues, and implications for agriculture. We posed the question to the students, should North Carolina citizens support biotechnology? And the title of the project, Biotechnology, Yay or Nay, since they had to take a stance and back up their claim with research and information they learned in the unit. As an element of our design process, we had an entry event where we presented students with groups of students at their tables with a scenario involving biotechnology where they had to make a decision as to whether or not that biotechnology should be used as a group. The project requirements were presented, and the students had a choice between digital media, written media, or video media to create their final product. They had to sign a group contract where they were holding each other accountable and could potentially remove someone from the group who wasn't fulfilling their obligations in conjunction with meetings with the teacher. They were given a graphic organizer to outline their thoughts before they began the final product, a rubric, so they knew exactly how they could earn the best grade possible. They completed a group reflection where they responded to specific questions and submitted a video in Flipgrid, and they filled out a peer feedback form for the other groups that presented for Grows and Glows. The four C's were a very large part of this project. Critical thinking, where they had to synthesize information to form a stance and justify the stance. They collaborated with each other and held each other accountable. Their creativity was illustrated in their choice of final product, and their communication was within the group with each other and to the class and the public when they presented. The career awareness was a very large part of this project. The careers and trades that I had exposure to were welding and HVAC repair, so I was able to talk to students about those and the need for those skills and those trades in the workplace. The careers in STEM through Novozymes and Duke Energy, and the careers in biotechnology with Novozymes. The college and career readiness was also a part of the SummerSTEM program that I got to learn about Wake Tech Community College's partnership with high schools, where students could learn trades and simultaneously earn college credit while they're still in high school. And I was able to present this and talk to my students about it as they start to think about careers, since they will be in high school next year. As you can see, this was a great project. This was a great experience. Students did a great job with this project, and they were very excited about it, and the presentations were phenomenal. Thank you so much.